Welcome back to Face the TV, ladies and gents, for our coverage of the GSL Egamingbets Cup. And not to be confused with GOM Star League, it's nothing to do with the Koreans. Unfortunately, they're not moving into CS, to my knowledge. Is that correct, Foreign? Anything happening over in Korea for CS?
I think they just play like Crossfire over there, don't they?
Yeah, that's true. Crossfire's pretty huge. Looks like we are live, though, into the pistol round, it seems. And NIP getting the CT side. Two players, like, load out on the actual site. And it seems like Kick are just playing it slow for the pistol round. They've got Emotion here in Radio Room trying to take pot shots into the ramp. Three players in Radio Room. Looks like they haven't committed to a play just yet, but they really want that radio badly. And Fifflerin is going to be in a really nice position to defend if they try to rush through. Got that grenade ready. Perfect timing on the throw there. Fifflerin going to go in. Great plays with the 5-7, spamming two down. But Kick will make the play onto that ramp successful. Getro's coming in slowly from the ladder room. Going to find himself one player not really ready for that. But NIP not going to lose Getro just yet as he falls back, taking things very cautiously, and Kick actually hanging around in the ramp room still.
And this is a big mistake actually by Fox.
Looks like NIP are just controlling the situation now, taking down all the players. They know where the bomb is. It's just Mataris left, and Getro's there with the 5-7, and he's going to take him down. So what did you make of that push into the ramp? Once they had the ramp, you called out a mistake from Fox. You feel like they held it too long?
The way they did it there, I don't think like pushing up under the ladder is the right move on the pistol round. You either want to go straight down and get the bomb down or pull back immediately, because you notice the NIP players didn't go through the door immediately. So you could have still gone up or after some of them have dropped down. The big mistake was they let Getright get all the way in, take free shots into a guy from behind when all they were holding was the ramp room. That's the one area where it should be impossible to be surprised if you're the T's, because all of you are there and you're all holding it, and yet you almost let a guy die because of that.
And Exist is just having a field day with a P90 there over at the heart. They're going to take down all the players. Anti-eco successful, not dropping a single man. And Famuses and P90s there, pretty awesome. P90 did receive a nerf not so long ago, though. Unfortunate for the people who love to stomp pubs with it, and that was a lot of people. But it seems as if we're going to have a buy from Kick. Some AKs, some Galils in there. We've got Fox moving first man on the outside. There goes the smoke, though. It's going to really hurt visibility, and a smoke over at ramp as well. So NIP slowing down Kick massively with those smokes means that they got to wait for the smokes to dissipate before pushing in. And Fox, though, is going to make his way onto T-Red on the outside, looking for that player that could be a secret. Forrest long range with the FAMAS here. Here he goes, trying to spray down or tap down some of those players. He does manage to take down Fox, which is a brilliant result with the FAMAS at that range. And falls back to the ramp. So they've taken down one player. Kick after.
And look at this. Getright could see the shadow of the guy above him. So he knows there's a guy up there now, which is the guy with the AWP, I think.
And they're coming together, moving into CT main, dropping Getright, and Fifflerin going to try and take a poke now. Needs some information to be able to flank properly, but it looks like two players from Kick are going to be there to greet him. The pistol comes out for the finish on the second player, but he's not going to be able to do it. Forrest, though, controlling outside, controlling main, beautifully with the FAMAS. And that's going to be NIP in a very controlled fashion, taking that round down. And that was a buy from Kick, so now they're going to have very little as they didn't get the bomb plant. So NIP in a great position now.
Playing really slow like this versus NIP when they're on CT side is a really, really bad move, because their strength is communication. And what you've seen, as we saw in the game before, is that Forrest and Getright have played together so long, they have really good communication. So anytime Forrest was looking over there, Getright would pull back a little bit and go to a more inside position on the entrance. Then when Forrest would go inside or look away, that's when Getright would peek out and he'd look. And so the timing on when they swapped was really, really good. And that's not something they've practiced like overall. It's just the communication. They know what the other one means, or when he's going to go there and I'm going to go here.
So it's just one player lost for NIP so far, and the bomb is outside. So another great frag there from Emotion. But that's not going to do much more than a couple frags. So going to have another buy coming. Portuguese team. What do you feel like they should be doing this round? Should they go for something fast? They took it slow previously.
if you do slow tactics, then you're relying on the fact that your read on the round is going to be more accurate or make a better decision than the opponent. And I would imagine that's not going to happen for kick. So personally, if I were them, yeah, I wouldn't necessarily go super, super fast, but I'd go to a medium speed and see what happens then. Like, do you get into 2v2 situations? Are you getting the entry kills? If not, then try maybe an even faster round.
Yeah, definitely. Looks like they're going to be waiting for picks at the moment, just holding positions. A couple players on the outside. The smokes are going to cover them, though. They're going to be able to gain some ground outside due to that. And secret's open, but there is one player down there tossing over a flash to delay. And that's some good information that they can relay to Freiburg there, or Freiburg can relay to his team, rather. And Get Right, we can see actually creeping around the back. Here he goes for the flank, what he does best. And two players spotted, one taken down, very controlled. But actually, Emotion turns around in time to deal with Get Right. Exists now.
But that then allows Forrest to instantly kill him because of the communication.
And Exist was ready for this last contingency play. I mean, they had three players in lobby awaiting the outcome of what happened over at Secret to make that push in. Perhaps they were banking on a preemptive, or early rather, rotation from NIP. But it didn't seem to really work out for them. Exist could hear them stepping all over lobby, and it was pretty easy for him after that. So 5-0 for NIP as Kick now have another buy, but what can they do with it this time? Looks like they have the same setup as the previous round, so I don't think they're upping it to a medium pace, although they are pushing outside rather fast. Get Right going to take down Fox, but Emotion, very good timing there to get the revenge kill. And we have Ramp held down, very safe right there from Forest. Emotion outside, look at that, beautiful play from Exist. Gonna take down Emotion, that's really important there. If Emotion had gotten to the window room in time, the angles wouldn't have been good for the NIP players. Here Kick go, moving into Ramp finally. But it's just too difficult. Great, great little setup from Fifth and Forest. I mean, it just seems like we're seeing every buy round is the same more or less so far, Thorin.
Well, the story is the same every time, which goes like this. NIP, Kick go really slow. They take the first 1v1 fight. Maybe they get a kill, maybe they get a trade. They never come out on top of it. And then based on that information, NIP gradually rotates better and better, uses more communication, accurately relays it to their teammates, and so the final engagement is always the Kick players just running into two NIP players looking at their exact position.
It looks like they're just gonna throw everyone at Ramp here. There goes the bomb down. NIP know exactly what's happening. Fifferin spraying down Motorist there. Seems like a relatively evil defense, easy defense, and an evil defense coming in from NIP. So, having seen these rounds from Kick not go well at all, are we just waiting for them to take it really fast now? Like a really fast.
I don't think that's going to happen because now Fox has got an AWP, so I'd imagine it's going to be slow again, as they're just going to set up and then wait for him to get a pick. Which the problem is, this style of play doesn't work against NIP. I mean, first of all, I don't know why teams are playing NIP on Nuke. That's like NIP's basically their best map since they don't play Train, so I wouldn't want to play them on their best map. But obviously, these teams think they know something that I don't know, so you'd think they'd come in with a strategy like, okay, well, if it's NIP's best map, then we have all this info on them. We know how to play versus them. But at the moment, it looks almost as though they have no idea what they're going to do against NIP except just try and hit headshots.
And it was good of Mutharis to get a pick onto Fiffler in Ramp. That is, I think, the first Byron we're seeing from them where they get the early advantage.
You've waited all this time to get an AWP on the Fox and you immediately lose it like that.
Yep, and all the players just go down. NIP just know exactly what's happening. And Freiburg, oh, great kill onto RMN through the door. And a quick cleanup on the second, Mutharis. So they got the opening frag on Fiffler at the start of the round. That was before any of them had died. They still have five men. What is a good play from that position, Thorin? What would you command Kick to do if you're the in-game leader? You get the pick on the Ramp guy. What should they be doing?
I would probably then just like send the first person out the ramp, but then everyone else hits the upper really hard. Because when the first guy is spotted by the other ramp guy, at least he might call some sort of a rotation. So that's when you could possibly get into upper.
Nice bit of spam there through the door. That timing worked out very well. Managed to dink. Get right through that door, so knocking him down a bit. But it's still 8-0 in favor of NIP, of course. CD side, the favored of the sides. Fox trying to work some positioning outside, but he may just come into contact with Thorist at some point soon. They don't really have much control of outside. NLP have kind of given it up mostly.
Well, if you've noticed, one of the big mistakes they make as well, Kick, is that the same players go to the same spots every time on Terrorist side. So if I even spot someone there, I know by the pace of he's going which tactic it's going to be and where they're going to hit. Like, I know it's going to be ramp here. I already know that just based on the fact that they're going so slow outside and they're refusing to peek at all upper. So the guys who stay ramp, they only stay ramp when they go ramp. So that means it has to be ramp. Now you've killed them both, so now you know it's not ramp. So now you're rotating back over, and now you'll probably see, look, exists looking for a man coming in outside. So he knows there must be someone around there. And he's actually right, but they're going to get into the upper side, it looks like.
And actually, the playmaker could have been Fox after the initial failure to Fiffler and, you know, two players getting killed at ramp.
Do you see the problem there, though, is that even when you hit upper, you got the best case scenario, you got your opening kills. But because of the communication and the information that Nip had based on your positions before, you could only have been hitting upper. They knew there was one guy outside, but that was it. There was going to be upper and outside. Like, it was never going to be a rush out to secret. It was never going to be ramp. Like, even the guys who were left alive for Nip, just know, just stay in this one spot and, okay, I have to get kills, but this is the one spot they're going to be.
And great pick from Fox there again, and they're just rushing up site through the door, taking down all the defense on the upper site, and it's just Forrest and Fiffler in now, and Forrest going to go for some spam, not going to get that lucky with it, and this should be a round for Kick. It's 4 versus 2, they've all got AKs, the bomb is down. Fifferin is entering the situation from CT main. Smoked up though at the moment, so he might have a chance to get at least one or two frags, but it's going to be a tall order here for NIP to take this one back. Time is ticking away and Fifferin is dealt with. It's just Forrest remaining. It's going to catch two headshots, looking for the triple. Does find it, and can he get the last kill? Will he have time for the bomb if he even does?
But he can possibly get this kill.
He's just going to go for the straight-up defuse, going to get the frag, but as you said...
I mean, that doesn't even matter, right? He had to go for it anyway because of how much money they have, but he got the best-case scenario almost, which is that he killed everyone on the team. He killed four guys, so you've stolen guns from them immediately.
That is a pretty big economic dent, especially for Kick, who were losing every single round.
Yeah, they just won that round and had the bomb down, yet they've had to spend nearly all their money on the whole team, just because Forrest killed four of them. See, actually, his play there without winning the round totally... money fucked the Kick guys, basically.
It did indeed, and it's 9-1 at the moment, and Kick, every single round is at such, like, even when they're winning, that it feels like they're losing, and Get Right opening up the round with the two quick kills.
And now we all
outside.
Know it's going to be the ramp room, because again, based on who's left alive and where they've shown, it has to be ramp.
Yeah, powers of deduction. And...
now Freeburg would have even gone for a knife there for the extra money. See, this is the thing. Now, when it comes to this round now, look at the money on Kick. No one can buy, and yet they would have, four of them would have had guns this round if they hadn't have died in the 1v6 situation. Now, obviously, some of them would have died anyway because they had to be versus Forrest, who's a more skilled player, and they had to defend the bomb. You can't just let him defuse a bomb. So some of them would have died anyway, but four of them dying would have been pretty unlikely. So actually, that one small, weird throwaway play from Forrest has now actually won his team an extra round, potentially, even though he didn't win that round.
And here goes a Molotov to try to block any upper rushes, fast upper rushes, but Freiburg's just going to take control here, just dropping down like a boss with a quad kill there. Great stuff from Freiburg, as he is a boss. That's basically what that just said. He just dropped down, cleaned up the situation, and Kick... without any money for a buy. They're just short of, okay, they're going to force the buy and just not many nades or anything for them. Just enough. We'd expect perhaps a rush at this point from Kick. I mean, a well-executed...
I wouldn't miss what we've seen so far. I'd expect the
I'd love to see a rush at least.
But they are all going outside at least. Yeah, the problem is if you go outside really slowly, now you'll see someone rotate inside. Like, you'll see someone come ramp from Nip, and then you'll see someone go in the hut, and then they'll say that there's no one there, and then you'll be completely pincered outside.
Yeah, Thoris has already rotated, as we can see, to the window room. And just tapping through that smoke to try to catch a player. But no one going to get caught just yet. They're taking it very slow outside. At least they are making the effort now down onto the lower site. And there goes the Molotov. Quite nice. And Freiburg actually will take down one before he gets killed. Which is...
you can see, again, the communication means they're totally locked in now. Because now Forrest knows to cover the outside secret entrance. Get Right's already inside looking towards the vents. and now the rest of them are just going to go down. So they've got them trapped into this one area now, and now only crazy headshots can get you out of this situation.
And here's Forrest going to catch Fox completely off guard. No problem at all. And it's 4 versus 3 at the moment for Kick, who are kind of just, they've just paused at the moment, trying to just work their way onto that plant on the lower site, trying to work out where NIP or the NIP players are. They've figured out get rights over there at the ramp. Emotion knows he's got time to go for the plant, got the cover from his teammates. And they do have an okay post-plant setup, but it's going to be pretty tough, actually. NIP, it's a 4 versus 3, and here comes Exist through the vents. They're timing it very well, but Emotion turns around just in time to kill Exist in the vents. Emotion is just a powerhouse this round. What else can he show us? Looking for the frag onto Fiffler, and he's going to find it. One player left, it's Get Right. Get Right will take down Emotion, but Emotion already did so much damage.
It's pretty much won the round here, so that doesn't really matter for them. Nip loses the round, but as a result, what won them the round there was one guy going crazy and killing everyone, which you can't plan for, and that can't be your strategy, okay? That has to be like a bonus to the strategy that was already working that makes it easier, whereas that was more like the strategy would have completely failed if that guy didn't just go nuts and kill everyone.
Yeah,
so
exactly.
Good round for Kick now, but good round in terms of the omen for the rest of the game? Probably not.
They absolutely need the next 2 rounds. There's just like no question about it to have any chance at all. I mean, 11-4 is...
And now Fox is going to be really fucked because they're going to aggressively push up on him now.
Well played again from Emotion, carrying that momentum from the last round into the next one, taking down Freiburg on T-Red. And Getroy's still there though, trying the oldest trick in the book, two players on the same spot and staying hidden. And Getroy finally reveals himself to take down Fox and Kick.
Getroy's going to now tell his team, okay, no one there, which means, again, deduction means quite simply, we know pretty much no one's showing up us, so the guys are ramp again. Let's see where it's going to be. It's going to be ramp.
And Fiffler, and they line up for him. There's the triple. And that's going to be the round 12-2. So moving on to the last round of the first half. And things are looking increasingly worse for Kick. NIP, though, they're just too strong. Too strong. So let's see now if Kick are going to be able to at least get the last round. They've only got pistols, though, so it's going to be pretty amazing if they manage to do it. And here goes Freiburg once again, is protecting the door. And there he goes, the spray comes into play. Only takes down one player though, but Get Rice is picking them off. And look at that, Fox coming in from the CT main. But that's not going to be enough. It's going to be a CT victory on the last round of the first half. 13-2 there, and Kick, they are very sad at the moment.
I mean, it's not even an exaggeration to say the same players went to the same positions as Terrorist every single time. The same players always pushed initially when they were going to that site, and they all just played trying to get kills. They never showed upper and then went ramp. They never showed ramp, then went upper. They never went outer all at the same time really quickly and went down. If they went anywhere, they went slowly. It was always trying to take like 2v3 situations, 2v2 situations initially going to the sites, and we saw how badly that worked out for them against one of the best CT teams on this map in the entire world who were amazing at rotations. He played right into their hands, basically.
Wow, and NIP are just dominating outside. This is getting quite ridiculous. Forrest trying to make his way through to ramp there. Exist, and his teammate's going to follow suit. You know, just drive by Glock action onto Fox as they run into that ramp room. And it's a 4-on-4 situation, and Kick have so much information at the moment, so they should be able to really have a good chance to defend or prevent a plant here. And you can see NIP kind of realize that. They're just taking it slower at this point, realizing they don't want to get into terrible positions and just run into the fire of Kick. So they are just waiting for Kick to make a mistake here on positioning and grab a frag. And you can see they're rotating back around into lobby here through ramp because they have so much space to work with. They're using it. And here they go, rushing into the upper bomb site. Can they get that bomb plant? The bomb is dropped. Fox taking down Exist. And Forrest does get a trade, though, but the bomb is still down. And
they're both in the vents as well, so they're going to try and pop up and get those initial kills. But unfortunately, now they're going to be trapped in those positions.
So NIP, you're really doing a great job to get the bomb down here. Again, as you said, playing in the vents. 2-on-2, though, for CT main. Can he win the duel? Here comes Mutheris trying to take another duel here with Fiffler.
Forrest, when Forrest gets up the ladder here, this will be the round win for Nip, I think.
And there you go.
He actually shows and dies. Amazing. He actually didn't need to show at all there, basically. He could have forced the CT to go to it as the bomb's going down and killed him while he's defusing. But he shows. I mean, you have to realize Nip's up so much, they're certainly going to win. They're just kind of, they're not trying to play like the perfect way or whatever. But a good round for a kick because it went in their favor. They got this small advantageous play and they made the most of it.
Yeah, and now we're seeing the buy coming in from kick, of course. So let's see how this round goes. NIP on the pistols. Hopefully kick don't, you know, drop rounds like these. It would be quite sad to see, even if we are somewhat sure of the end result of this. Let's see kick put up a good defense on this anti-eco. NIP just taking it pretty slow at the moment, not doing a straight out rush just yet. And here we go though, Fifferin does manage to make his way down to secret as we saw so often in the last game as well. But he does go down. So who's going to try their luck next from the NIP team to try to push into kick? And so far, they're just keeping it slow still. Private taking a peek, trying to get some information. Decides to just go for it, and it feels like NIP now, again, you know, committed to just making a play on the ramp or something, and they're going to get dropped by the FAMAS. In come the pistols, in comes Fox's M404, and there goes the round for kick. So they do get at least one round there, as they should. But here comes some weapons, some AK-47s for NIP. So can they win this round? That's really the question. And what kind of plays are you expecting from NIP? Are they going to get bold, just be aggressive?
I would expect they'll do what we saw against NYM. They'll just feel them out initially. They'll try and push one area a little bit, see what the reaction is. Then they'll just base the next rounds on how that goes particularly. They won't have set strategy that they're going to hard counter and just rush this no matter what. So at the moment, they're doing the same thing they did at the beginning of the other game, which is push outer initially and see what the reaction is to that. How do they hold it? How do they push you back? When do they rotate on you?
All right, and actually three of them pushed down secret. Fox will defend. They've got two players there, but both of them go down. In unison, that target selection from Forest Exist was perfect. And now Garrett still, he just cuts off Mudaris's head. And RMN is going to try to take the revenge frag, and he will find it with the Pro 90. So two versus two now, and RMN is going to pick up that AK, so they have a chance, and the bomb is not down yet. So kicks can still do this. Bomb is trying to get planted slowly, but they really don't have a full grasp of the position of... Oh, nice shot there with the FAMAS. So now 2-on-1, and they know where the bomb is. It's just a case of playing it correctly here. Perhaps not the most ideal positions from kick, but they should hear the bomb get planted, the plant sound, and that should be the cue to go as soon as Exist grabs it. They're playing so defensively right now.
Yeah, I would actually, if I was the kick guy, I'd rather they were a little more aggressive so that as soon as one spots them, you can both be attacking him at the same time. I don't like to attack one after the other. But then again, Exist was kind of hoping they'd peek him and he could just maybe kill them.
And he's just going to go for it then. No other play available to him.
I think what happened there is, I'll go through the mind of Exist there. He's hoping initially someone peeks the vents or the ramp, and then he can kill them before he has to plant because he still had about 35 seconds. Then he can make it a one-on-one, and then at least he can gamble. Like, okay, I think he won't come out the vent if I plant from this angle. Whereas if he's 1v2, if he imagines they'll play like I suggested, like they'll play more aggressively, looking to get the information and both attack at the same time, then it's going to be hard to plant or even get into the 1v2 to actually win it.
Yeah, definitely. And it's like NIP is Freiburg.
Yeah, kick's lost the man here.
They did indeed drop to four players. Unfortunately, NIP going to make their way through a hut as Freiburg makes his way through the ramp. They're going to get taken down, most of them. It's 2-on-2, though, unfortunately, still, you know, they are missing that one player. And Fox is down on the lower site. He's got a teammate emotion in the vents, and they're just waiting for the sound cues at this point. They have decent enough positions. It's about working out what NIP are going to go and commit for. And there's 50 seconds left in the round. And Kick's last man does rejoin the server. So that's good news for Kick. But NIP still, you know, they have
Emotion is
seconds.
In position to get this kill on a Freiburg if he just sticks around.
That is,
Freiburg's
going to
go down there again.
A lot to be said for patience in this game. And...
In fact, Nip's actually, if kick, as long as they don't show, are in pretty good positions.
Oh my god, Fox gets caught in a terrible spot there. And at least Emotion's able to equalize the player
count. With the
time
left on the clock now, he can actually use the clock against them now. Because he doesn't have to show until like a second or two from now. Now he has to peek to check if they're planting. He actually gambles that they aren't, and they aren't. This is the correct play. Now he can just kill him.
Very well played from Emotion, who has been making massive plays. He's been the one, the primary factor for Kick, just keeping them in the game so far.
Well, if you remember, he was the player who won that round at lower when it was on the terrorist side, which is one of the few rounds they actually won, like, legitimately, just by killing everyone. So he's clearly showed the most game sense in this round here. He played that very well. He used the clock against him. He used flashes against him. He held him in position and knew that the terrorist, well, he gambled, but he intuitively made a good gamble that the terrorist wouldn't just go and plant. Freeberg played correctly as well because he used the bomb to bait him out and at least get a shot to win the round. But yeah, it was well played by Emotion, I have to say.
And here we go. They are pressuring the upper site, trying to get some peeks through the door, and they're going to get punished. Fox is going to drop Forest as well. Great double from Fox, taking down both players outside. That really cuts the effort from NIP in half. They only have two players left now, moving slowly into the ramp. This is really what probably feels like their last option. They burned most of the grenades. Got to try to get into this room. Going to take the one-on-ones.
So it's not a problem right now. There's still time. They've still got full health. They've got the bomb. At the moment, you had enough. Even before that, they got those kills. It was still very doable.
Again, Emotion is playing fantastically, taking the last man exist down to 37 health, a critical condition. And again, we're back into a one-on-one. Mutaris has to try to stop, or rather get the defuse right here against exist. And there he does spot him. He knows his position, even catches him with a few bullets as he tries to go around that. Oh, there you go. The grenade is going to do the job. Well played to Kick. Again, Emotion and Fox really coming out huge in that round again.
No, I mean, if you're Nip, then, you know, like my Zen master used to tell me, you have to make sure that Emotion doesn't get the better of you.
Oh, there we go. I'm kind of a bit jealous, so I didn't think of that. I mean, although it is pretty lame, but still.
No, the lame ones are the best ones, DDK. The lame ones are the best ones.
That's true. And 37, I mean, this is getting into much more respectable territory. It was really looking like NIP were just playing, just toying with Kick as if they were on, well, they are on a different level, but as if they were just a new team that had just picked up the game a week ago. But Kick are really bringing this back off the strength of Emotion, the strength of Fox. They are really doing such a fantastic job now, but it doesn't end here. They still got to keep this going, keep the ball rolling. And Freiburg is all the way pushed to the vents here. He's going to catch Emotion. That is a really, really big frag to pick up as the first frag of the round. And he has so much map control now. Also, and it's the pressure that he's putting on the NIP, on the Kick team, rather, the CT side, by being in the vents. And this really shakes up the defense of Kick and the positions that they can hold safely. And here you have NIP, the entire team, moving through secret, moving down into the lower site. And here they go, getting ready. Forrest on the angle, a friend opening the door for him. And, oh, and he gets the shot. And now they go straight into the site for the plant. It's the methodical play from NIP. It's just beautiful to witness at the moment. Fifflerin, and, yep, there you go.
See, the thing is, if I was NIP, losing those last rounds and the score creeping a little bit closer, I'm not at all worried by that, because all the rounds I'm losing on gun rounds, I always get to a 1v1, or I'm in a 1v2, or I plant the bomb, or I had a chance at winning the 1v1. When you're on a CT-sided map like this, that suggests the actual tactic that you're picking is working. Now, you're not getting the result you want, but if you can keep running that, it's going to work over and over again. You're going to win some of those 1v1s, some of those 2v2s. And that time, they completely decimate them, and that just looked easy the way they got down there.
And now we have problems with Kick, who only have pistols. And if NIP win this, they go 15 rounds to the 7 of Kick. So this is a pretty huge round to see something quite ridiculous from Kick. And it's not going to happen just yet. All but one player left. And he is easily dealt with as well. So 15 to 7, now just one round away from victory. NIP steamroll forwards. And in case you guys are wondering, the match after this will actually be NIP versus H2K. So getting a lot of NIP games in today. This is just Group A play today. Tomorrow we have Group B. And on Friday we have the playoffs for this GSL Egamingbets Cup with $2,000 up for grabs. And there goes the flash outside. We can see NIP once again, as it always has been, Fifflerin making the move in the yard. And Kick are doing okay. They've managed to kill Fifflerin. So NIP lost their kind of front man, their flanking man there. And here goes Freiburg right around. Entry fragger extraordinaire. Mutarist going to get the trade though, and Exist and Forest taking down the control of the upper bomb site. We've got Kill Dreams coming up the ladder. What can he do? It's a one-on-two situation. Cannot drop Forest in time. The AWP is too strong. GG's all around. 16-7, the final score, as NIP take another victory here today in Group A. So any interesting thoughts perhaps on that one, Thorin?
Pretty much as expected. It's NIP on Nuke. They're going to be really good on CT side. T side, they're always going to get rounds because just how good their team is executing. Get right on Forest, own everyone, pretty much what you'd expect. Yeah, I think all in all, by the numbers.
Certainly, I think that is really all there is to say on that. So guys, look forward to NIP versus HTK, which will be the next match that's going to come up after the break. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.